There's a lot of talk amongst the Vancouver Canucks fan base on Tanner Pearson. And first off, I'd like to establish that Tanner Pearson, all these discussions that we're having now are very good. They're very, very good. And they're very good because no matter what, these discussions, the outcome that we have with Tanner Pearson, it's 100% better than what we would have had with Erica Branson. Just know that first and foremost, folks. So Tanner Pearson is a player who, going into next season for the Vancouver Canucks, not too many people are super confident on whether or not he's a top six guy or a top nine guy. Because Pearson, coming over to the Vancouver Canucks after being with the Pittsburgh Penguins, he scored himself 9 goals and 12 assists in 19 Vancouver Canucks games. And that's really, really good. That's half a goal a game, and his immediately found chemistry with a guy like Bo Horvat was instantly noted by the fanbase. So, going into next season, there are people saying that, hey, okay, Tanner Pearson, it's his time to shine. He's 26 years old, he's almost 27. I believe he turns 27 in August, so he's coming into his prime years. Pearson is a guy who worked well with Bo. Next season, 2019-20, is going to be the opportunity that Pearson needs to truly reestablish himself as a top six forward in the NHL. And for the most part, I completely agree. Some people are out there saying, okay, Pearson, how do we know he's a top six guy? Is he a top nine guy that was disguised as a top six guy towards the end of last season? Or is he just a top nine guy, period? And to that, I kind of wanted to combat a little bit, because Pearson is a player who did have chemistry with Bo in the 19 games that he did play. And the fact of the matter is here, the Vancouver Canucks are in such a desperate need for wingers that are top six caliber, that when an opportunity like this presents itself where you have a guy who did have chemistry with a guy like Bo Horvat, and you need to decide where to put him, this is the chance where you have to say, okay, we're playing him in the top six. Pearson has done all he could in his limited 19 games with the Vancouver Canucks last season to prove that he at least deserves a shot with Bo Horvat in 2019-20. Because if you take a look at Pearson and what he did last season and you say, okay, he was good, but next season we're starting you on the third line with Brandon Sutter, Gaudette, or Beagle, that's kind of a slap in the face. Because if you kick off 2019-20 with Vertanen and Berchi on Bo Horvat's wing, then you're doing Tanner Pearson a misservice. Because you're taking his limited body of work and you're saying, yeah, that doesn't really matter, we're going with what we feel is right now. Because Pearson did establish himself as a good NHL player with the Canucks. So going forward in the next season, this is Pearson's time to shine alongside of Bo Horvat. And if I'm going to be honest, I'm expecting 20, 22, 23 goals out of Pearson. I'm not going to sit here and expect 41 because he was scoring at half a goal a game. And that roughly translates to about 40, 41 goals. I'm not going to expect that out of Tanner Pearson. But 20, 25 goals or whatever, that's approximately the ballpark that I think Pearson is able to achieve, just off of the chemistry that he showed with Bo last season and just the resume of work that Pearson has had in the past. Remember, Pearson made his NHL debut pretty much into the Los Angeles Kings playoff run. He was amazing with that 70s line. Toffoli, and I believe it was Jeff Carter as well, they were all amazing players, a huge top six line there, and they won the Stanley Cup in 2014 with that line. So Tanner Pearson, as a guy who is just 5 years removed from that, and a guy who was just 2 years removed from having 40 points overall in a season, is definitely somebody who I can say, yeah, he's got a resume of work to build around and somebody that I can confidently put effort in to developing as a 40-point, 20-goal guy alongside of Bo Horvat. Bo Horvat needs wingers, and he hasn't had a solidified line to be with him probably since, like, the BBB line in 2017-2018. That was an incredible line, and aside from that, he's been shuffled around with guys like Spooner and, like, Gagne and Vertanen and Eriksson. Horvat last season didn't have a consistent winger, and the fact that we have Pearson, who is now a player who had some really good chemistry with Bo, I think this is the one opportunity to really showcase that, yes, Bo Horvat does have a winger on this team that can stick with him throughout the year. And Pearson has the opportunity to be that guy. So, looking forward into things now, I'm really looking forward to what Tanner Pearson will be able to bring to the Vancouver Canucks. Again, I'm not expecting 41 goals. I'm expecting roughly around 20-ish, maybe 35 to 40, 45 points in its entirety if Bo Horvat is able to consistently stay at that 60-point pace as he was last season. So, honestly, I'm really looking forward to this, and especially the fact that we got this guy for Gudbranson. It really puts a smile on my face. So, anything that Pearson does, it's better than Gudbranson. I don't care how good Gudbranson is with Pittsburgh, Gudbranson wasn't really all that special here. And the fact that this player was able to land us Pearson, who was equally ineffective in Pittsburgh, it makes me quite happy. So, Canucks fans, comment down below what you think. Hope you enjoyed this video social-rosas99. And bye.